In Florida's biggest cities, state troopers use a special tool for enforcing traffic laws on dangerously congested highways.
It's different from being in a car. You don't have the armor around you, so you definitely got to be careful about people pulling out in front of you. You have to stay alert at all times. You have your heat, the humidity in the mornings, you're sweating all day in the summertime. And then most of the time in the afternoons, here comes the rain, and that makes the road slick. The oil comes up top. I mean, you got to really be on your P's and Q's on that motorcycle at all times. We actually try to train once a month, you know, to stay proficient. Motorcycles that we ride weigh close to 1,000 pounds with all the equipment on it. So it's a pretty heavy bike. The slower you're traveling, the harder it is to balance the motorcycle. The throttle and your clutch has to be just right, and your braking has to be just right, and everything is pretty much tight turns. But you get used to that. It becomes natural. I thought I was very good at riding a motorcycle until I applied for the position of being a motor officer. It's tough. It's a very tough course.
You go through the police motorcycle school, you soon realize what you do not know. And you learn so many things. I mean, how to maneuver on the motorcycle. You travel 40 miles an hour, you have to stop and turn. It was extremely tough. You question yourself. That first week, I'm thinking, do I really want to do this? You know, do I really want to be a motorman? Because this is hard.
It is completely different to ride an everyday motorcycle, whether it be a sport bike or a cruiser. And then after you get through this course, just going through the course itself was pretty tough. But after you get out of the course, my perspective on motorcycles in traffic changed completely from night to day.
We're primarily traffic. So when we come out in the morning, we come out to look and enforce the law right away. We don't have to worry about other things that happen within our zone or the county. The patrol car units take care of it. We come out there and we just make sure the traffic flows safely and we keep everybody in check.
We go out and enforce traffic on a day-to-day basis. We have certain areas that we concentrate on. Sometimes we do traffic light enforcement. Sometimes we do seat belt enforcement. A couple of days a week we do speed enforcement. One guy is out clocking the vehicles with a laser. He'll call the car out, but lane the car is in. We go after that vehicle. It's easy. You can get to that vehicle much easier than a car can. And it's one behind another. It's one behind another when they come along and speed through that area.
During rush hour traffic, there's very little highways that are not bumper to bumper. It's a lot harder for a patrol car to maneuver through traffic going lights and sirens than it is a motorcycle just to split lanes or get on the shoulder. It is more dangerous. However, it's easier to maneuver around through traffic.
Got a 77 in the outside lane, white color pink.
One girl that I pulled over, she started crying right away. She was a younger driver. She hadn't been driving that long, and she was pretty upset about getting pulled over. I think that may have been her first time.
Good afternoon, miss. Driver's license, registration, proof of insurance, please.
Well, she started fumbling around with that stuff, pulling her license out and stuff, and she was a little upset about getting pulled over. Got all of her information, gathered her information, walked back to the motorcycle, and it was kind of a surprise that the passenger got out of the car.
You know what, it's really almost my fault because I told her, no, we can't stop to eat, we gotta get down there to get the haircut.
And she was pretty apologetic. She was like, well, officer, it's my car. My daughter is driving, and I don't think she's ever been pulled over before, and she's just starting to drive. She really didn't want her to get a ticket, you know.
Okay, miss, I need your signature here. I just charged you for not having the registration. I explained to your mom, all you have to do is take it downtown and show it within 30 days, and they will dismiss that for $10. And don't get caught speeding by me again, okay? Slow down.
When I get the younger drivers, they just don't realize what they're doing. And when that happens and I get those kids, I try to tell them, say, hey, listen, you know, you're endangering yourself and the motor in public, and I'm here to prevent that. And some people will say, hey, you're right. And others, they don't care. So I just end up just writing the ticket and telling them, please slow down. And that's the best I can do. At the end of the day, I'm protecting that one teenager, that one person that's trying to get home to his family.
It's 4 a.m. on Father's Day morning. FHP traffic homicide investigators are called out to a collision on a rural highway in Manatee County.
As I was approaching the scene, you could see how the vehicle traveled off the road. You could actually see his marks, his tire marks, where he went off the road, traveled off the road for approximately 100, 150 feet, and then came back across the road. And he was just unable to maintain control of it, and unfortunately struck a telephone pole. The vehicle caught on fire.
When we have a death, we have to investigate it and determine why that person got killed, who's responsible for it, who's at fault, if there are any charges or criminal charges, and to actually get that information and document it for FHP and for the family, because the family will want to know what happened to their loved one.
When I arrive on scene, I just start gathering the information. In that particular case, it was pitch dark. There was no lighting whatsoever. So it made it very hard to collect some of the evidence that was there. It would happen at 4 o'clock, so sunrise was gonna be, you know, 6 or 7 o'clock. So I had to stay out there until I actually had some sunrise so I could actually see the whole scene. I think as a homicide investigator, you look at the scene a little bit differently. Sometimes the troopers might overlook something that we think is really important. I think it's just more detail when you're doing the traffic homicide investigation.
If we have tire marks or skid marks from the vehicle, we measure those to obtain the speed of a vehicle. We document where the body is, if it got ejected or if it's still in the vehicle. If you can actually see what a car does to a person when they have a crash, it tends to deter you from driving like you don't care. Not everybody can actually do homicide investigation because you get to a point where you get tired of seeing death. I've had fatalities where as young as 5 and 6. It bothers you, but I have a job to do. If I do my job, then I can get the loved one some satisfaction. Maybe I can get them some type of peace of mind about what happened to their loved one.